But first, I wanted to expound on my week and a half or so of experience with the Surface Pro 11. And I don't know if John has any questions because he's mostly Mac these days. But so a couple
of things. But one of the things I do want to talk about is actually a Windows thing in a few moments. So okay. I may have questions. I might surprise you. We will see.
So the first thing is I bought this from Costco, which, as you know, I've long called the center of technology.
Mm-hmm.
And in this case, this is really interesting because I found out, so I've got the Snapdragon X Plus, right, which is the lower tier Copilot Plus PC. The Sven Johansson, our buddy Sven Johansson, bought the Snapdragon X Elite, which is the higher tier. I think it has 12 core instead of 10 core and a lot of other nice stuff. It also has a nicer screen. He has an OLED screen. I just have a regular LED screen. But at any rate, one of the things I did discover is that if you try to order this Snapdragon X Plus Copilot Plus PC from Microsoft, the largest solid state drive you can get is 512 gigabytes. You can get 256 or 512. However, if you buy the bundle from Costco, it comes with a terabyte. And I don't know if it's available in this configuration from any place else but Costco. But so for those looking for, you know, a lower end, well, lower end, it's slightly cheaper, you know, less than $2,000. Copilot Plus PC, Surface Pro 11. But you still want a terabyte of storage, go head over to Costco and they have a bundle, mm-hmm. which has a terabyte of storage, 16 gigs of RAM, which is the minimum, by the way, for Copilot Plus PCs, and the Slim Pen, which is this guy right here, the which is pretty good.
Like an architect's pencil.
Carpenter's pencil, architect's pencil.
Architect. Yeah, architects probably don't want that big of a fat pencil. Carpenters like it.
And there's what I think they call the business Surface Pro business keyboard, which means that it is not the fancy dancy one that Sven got with Bluetooth. It is mechanically attached, magnetically attached with a mechanical connector, or it basically needs a connector. And it's okay as a keyboard. I mean, I can touch type on it and stuff. Although I did get a Bluetooth keyboard for it, which works great. It's one of these folding keyboards with, let's see if I can get the, turn it around here. And with a nice space bar I'm not doing it. I probably should turn off the background. But anyway, it has a nice space bar because it's not too small and it's not split. And by that, this is a relatively new keyboard from ProtoArch, which makes really nice keyboards in general. But I think you might be able to see that the keyboard, it's split, because it's ergonomic. But still, I keep hitting the blank spot because that's how I type, right in the middle of the keyboard or the space bar. But
those have always been interesting to me, the natural design, ever since Microsoft came out with the natural keyboard back in the 90s, some of them look like they work really well and some of them just do not look like they work really well. I think it's just purely up to your individual typing style, which is interesting to think about, that even as touch typists, if you're a touch typer, you don't have exactly the same style as every other touch typist out there.
Right.
So,
and you also don't have the same table height and your height, your chair, and so all of that. So I'm not an ergonomic expert, but I have gone through a lot of keyboards just this year. Keyboards over the last 40 or 50 years. I've tried a whole bunch of the ergonomic keyboards, including this one from ProtoArch, which is pretty nice actually. And what I found really was I had to learn to type differently because I do have a bit of carpal tunnel, not enough for surgery, thankfully. I've had friends go through that and they're never quite the same. But I do have a bit of carpal tunnel, but it hasn't flared up because I've tried to learn to type, as we say in Hawaii, mobera.
And I have a foldable keyboard here that's got a trackpad that I bought. bought this about 6 months ago or so, and I still have not been able to get my hand to be used to the layout of it. But yeah, I got it thinking, you know, there's times I'm using things like a Raspberry Pi or something where I need to have a wireless Bluetooth keyboard. But yeah, I just can't get my hands to wrap around strange new keyboards.
It does take a while. Some, you know, I've got a bunch in the last year, foldable keyboards and other things. And some of the new ones with, you know, with the, without the split right in the space bar are just working out way better than earlier designs I've used. And I've been using foldable keyboards since the early 2000 and aughts, I guess we would say. The beginning of the millennium.
It just sounds so epic.
I know. By the way, you know, I looked for the price. So that this Surface Pro business keyboard with the pen retails for $280. Okay, I get that the pen is like 120 or 30, which is the same price as Apple Pencil. But I do not understand why this keyboard is so expensive. I mean, you know, the Bluetooth one that I just showed you is like 40 or 50. It's very reasonable. Oh, the other thing is the Slim Pencil is slim, which is, and it's flat, so it doesn't fall off. But look how short it is. So let's see if can I share it.
That is much shorter than the Apple Pencil and a little bit shorter than the previous.
This one over here is a USI 2.0 pencil that works with some Android tablets and Chromebooks. And you can see how, you know, epically short it is. So I have got a third party, a non-Microsoft USB-C charged pencil, a stylus coming in, I think today. By the way, I will say that the Slim Surface Pen charges wirelessly, and it's got a little nice little slot right in the keyboard, and so it's always charged, and it works pretty well. In fact, if you look behind me, I tried the co-create mode in Microsoft Paint, and so on the let's see, I guess it's on your behind my fat head, which is what is that on your right, John?
Yes, my right. I see the larger over. Yeah, now I see over your left.
Right,
you're right.
Right shoulder, yeah. So that's my little, you know, 5 minute doodle using Microsoft Paint and stylus. And I think I make it bigger, but the little large, slightly larger than a thumbnail is co-create. And I said it on creativity, kind of on less than half, because it got way too creative and didn't even vaguely resemble my little doodle. But I thought it was kind of interesting. I'm not sure it justifies paying, you know, a lot of money to buy a Surface Plus, Copilot Plus PC, but it's kind of an interesting tool. Really, without Microsoft's recall feature for Copilot Plus PC, there's no real significant AI on this box. In fact, one of the things I discovered is, you know, it's supposed to have this smart mode for webcams. It only works with a webcam built into the Surface Pro. It does not work with any of my, you know, fairly high-end, well, not high-end, but higher-end webcams. These are, you know, $100 webcams or whatever that have, you know, tilt and all that stuff. And its own AI features, they're 4K, like this one that I'm using right now. So, anyway, so that's that. I've got a longer pencil coming in, but the Surface Pen, Slim Pen, is MPP 2.6, so Microsoft Pen Protocol 2.6. The one I've got on order is 2.0, so I think I lose something. I'm not quite sure what. It's less, has less resolution than this in terms of, you know, how it detects where you are on the screen, but we'll see. Yeah. I should get it sometime today, probably after the podcast. A couple of things, apps. So the one thing I really wanted to use, since I have a terabyte of storage, is Insta360 Studio for their 360-degree cameras and other cameras they have. It won't even install on here. And this is the ARM version. It says not a compatible device. it is beta, so you know, I'll give them that, but I'll try to be patient and I'll use a Mac or something else until then. But that would not install the HP Smart app for their printers. Installed, but would not launch until I restarted the PC. I had to, you know, like in the old days, I had to reboot the PC to get the app to work. But and as I mentioned, AI Windows Studio Effects only works with the Surface camera, as far as I can tell. I tried it with two other 4K webcams and nada. Everything else seems to install pretty nicely. Affinity Studio and Affinity Photo, which are like very reasonable priced alternatives to Adobe's products, which are, you know, on a subscription. These are one-time costs. Mm-hmm. My ARM version, by the way. So I've been really happy. Unlike my Surface RT experience in 2012,
where the experience we shall not speak of. I think for a lot of people, the Surface RT was an experience we shall not speak of.
Yeah, and it's too bad. Like I said, I wrote a very nice article about it because I had a lot of hope when I first got it, but that was very disappointing. So, anyway, so even though this has a really nice camera, in fact, I can switch to it temporarily. Let me switch. So I've been using, like I said, the OBSBOT Tiny 2 Lite. What a mouthful. And I'm going to switch to the Surface camera front. And as you can see, it's a much wider angle. So this Surface camera, much wider. I should note, by the way, I was going to do something fancy. I was going to try to use my Pixel 7a as a webcam to show you things like the keyboard. Google Meet, which we're using for this recording, said that my camera's shutter is on. This has no shutter. All the privacy settings are set correctly, I think. I'll go talk to Sven because I know he got it to work. So I'll talk to Sven later and see what he has to say. But that's sort of my 10 days of experience with the Surface Pro. Oh, and I mentioned it when we got it. This thing can run hot. It got up to 107 degrees on Google Meet. It feels pretty warm right now.
And that hasn't leveled out, you know, because I could see some people saying that might be something having to do with initial setup or.
Yeah.
You know, I don't have
Yeah, I don't have an IR thermometer handy. It's about 20 feet away from me, but it's not uncomfortably warm, but it's over 100 degrees, I'm pretty sure. Mm-hmm. Fortunately, because the computer itself and all of the innards are in the screen. It's only the screen getting hot. So the Surface keyboard, the one with the connector on it, which attaches magnetically, is, you know, cool as a cucumber, as people. And because, you know, it's got no electronics other than the keyboard and I guess a little charger for the Slim Pen. So
because I thought you were going to explain why people say cool the cucumber, you know,
I don't know.
Explain the oddities. I mean, I can have cucumbers that are kept cold, but you can also have warm cucumbers, you know, depending on what you, I guess no one ever intentionally tries to heat a cucumber, but I mean, if the salad sits out long enough and it comes up to room temperature, it's not very cool at that point.
It'd be warm as a cucumber.
Yeah, warm as a cucumber.
Yes, English is a funny language.